In cryptography, the Holy Grail is a true random number. Most services, Linux, etc. use a function called rand. This is software that generates a random number based on whatever entropy it can find. Temp, mass movement, time, bit of the shell, etc. These are never truly random results, but for most use cases they are more than adequate. However, over the years there have been many successful attacks against the random number generators that were used for many services and protocols. The key is in the entropy, randomness, used to start with. Using temperature, for instance, has a set of limits. Too hot and the computer would melt, too cold it won't turn on. So the entropy is limited and only creates a pseudo-random generator. Elliptic Curve Digital Signature Algorithm, ECSA, which is the core of cryptography in Bitcoin, uses this idea of pseudo-random generation. Every transaction in Bitcoin is required to be signed by the owner who owns the private keys. Apart from the private keys in each signature in ECSA, the user should generate a random number K, which should really be generated randomly for every single transaction that the user makes. In fact, if the same private key of a user with the same random number K is used twice, anyone can calculate his private key and eventually spend his money. This applies to any wallets in Bitcoin, including offline storage. Moreover, any linear relation between the two random number K and K in two different signatures compromises the user as private key. In 2015, coin exchange Bitstamp lost BX due to this problem, and 250 BX were lost from blockchain info due to the same errors during a security update. But ECSA was already known to have flaws. In 2010, Sony. You can read full post on CryptoFans. News, link available in text below.